In this video, we're going to solve examples from past questions. And those questions I'm going to solve will be based on the laws of logarithm. So let's get started. I'm going to use the question search feature of Best Driller UTME to search for questions. So the first thing I'll do is to select the subject, and then I want to look for questions related to logarithms. Then you search. So these are questions related to laws of logarithm. Now let's take the first question. We're going to take question 9 from 2003. The question states, I will evaluate log 4 to base root 2 plus log 16 to base 1 over 2 minus log 32 to base 4. So the question is, how do we solve this or evaluate this? One thing we want to do is to make all of them have similar base. That's one way to think about how to solve this, right? So how do you make all of them have similar base? By looking for ways by which you can make them as multiples of 2. So let's take a look at how to do that. So in this case, I'm going to take log 4 to base 2 raised to the power of 1 over 2. From the law of indices, m raised to the power of 1 over 2 is equal to the square root of m, right? So the next is we can express this other one as log 16 to base 2 raised to the power of minus 1. From the law of indices, we can, from law of indices, a raised to the power of minus m is equal to 1 over a raised to the power of m. So if I have 1 over 2, I can simply write as this. So the next is minus log 32 to base 2 raised to the power of 2, which is 4. The next is to take these powers to the back. Based on the laws of indices, laws of logarithm, if you take the power of a base to the back, you invert it, so which means this becomes 2 over 1 log 4 to base 2. Then if you take this to the back, it becomes plus into brackets minus 1 over 1. If you invert it, it's still minus 1. Then log 16 to base 2. Then this becomes log. If you take this 2 to the back, it becomes 1 over 2 log 32 to base 2. The next thing we can do is to simplify these numbers. That is, write them as multiple of 2. So that becomes 2 log. This becomes 2 raised to power 2 to base 2 plus times minus. That gives you minus. Then you have log 2 to raise to the power of 4. Then minus 1 over 2 log 2 to base 2 raised to the power of 5 to base 2. 32 is 2 raised to the power of 5. If you simplify this further, you're going to get, but if we're going to apply law of logarithm here, I'm going to bring down this 2. If you bring it out here, it becomes 2 log 2 to base 2. Then if you do the same thing here, it becomes minus 4 log 2 to base 2. Then if you take this, it becomes 1 over 2 times 5 log 2 to base 2. We know that log 2 to base 2 is equal to 1 from the log, for one of the laws of logarithm. So now this becomes 2 times 2 times 1. That becomes 4. Then this minus 4. Then this becomes minus 5 over 2. So 4 minus 4 will give us 0. 0 minus 5 over 2 becomes minus 5 over 2. And that can be expressed as minus 2.5. So this is the correct answer, which is option D. So move on to the next question. So this time around, we are going to look at 2004, question 36. So let's take a look. So in this case, we have if 6 log 2 to base x minus 3 log 3 to base x is equal to 3 log 0.2 to base 5. So the question says we should find x. So the question says we should determine the value of the base x. So how do you approach this problem? The first thing you want to do is you want to try to simplify the part without x. So let's see if we can simplify this section without x. And you also want to simplify the left side as well. But to simplify the left side, you have to take this power back. In other words, you have to express it as follows. 2 raised to the power of 6. So it's more or less like taking this back to this and taking this one back to this. So it becomes log 2 raised to the power of 6 to base x minus log 3 raised to the power. It's just like going the inverse direction of one of the laws. So this is raised to the power of 3 then to base x. We can do the same thing here. Or another thing we can do here is just to simplify this. To simplify this is to express this in terms of fraction, and that's 0.2 over. Okay, if you simply convert this to fraction, that's more or less like saying 2 divided by 10, right? Because if you can write 0.2 as 2 over 10, or 2 times 10 raised by minus 1. So then this is to base 5. So now, what can we do on this left side? We can apply the law that says if you have two logs with the same base, you can divide their numbers. So you can say something like 2 raised to the power of 6 divided by 3 raised to the power of 3 to base x. So now, the next thing is to simplify this, which is 3 log of, if you take this, it becomes 5, right? So it becomes 1 over 5 to base 5. We can write this as log of 5 raised to the power of minus 1. 1 over 5 is the same thing as 5 raised to the power of minus 1. Then this is in base 5. Then if you take this negative number to this side, it becomes minus 1 times 3, then log 5 to base 5, and that gives you log 5 to base 5 is equal to 1. So everything becomes minus 3. So now we have log 2 raised to the power of 6 divided by 3 raised to the power of 3 to base x equals to minus x. So if you apply one of the laws of indices, sorry, one of the laws of logarithm, you can easily express the number, which is 2 raised to the power of 6 divided by 3 raised to the power of 3 as equal to x raised to the power of minus 3. So you can express it this way. So what we want to do next is to simplify both sides, and let's see what we get. So from the previous page, we have 2 raised to the power of 6 over 3 raised to the power of 3 equals x raised to the power of minus 3. So we can try to look for, the idea is this. We can try to look for the cube root, or we can try to use different approach. But I'm going to use a relatively straightforward approach. So which is, if I want to get a value of x, so let's write it this way. Let's write it this way. I can multiply, I can add this exponent to both sides. So what that means is I can add this exponent. I can multiply both sides by minus 1 over 3. I can add this exponent to both sides. So I can say 2 raised to the power 6 over 3 raised to the power 3, everything raised to the power minus 1 over 3. So if you do what you did, if you add minus 1 over 3 on the left, you do that on the right. So this will ensure that we cancel out this whole thing. So everything becomes x. So that's the whole essence of multiplying by minus 1 over 3. So that minus cancels out minus. That is, minus times minus is plus, then 3 cancels out 3. So now how do we simplify this? So this is where we need to do a little bit of work. But it's relatively easy because from the laws of indices, you can multiply each of them by this power. In other words, you can say that 2 raised to the power 6 times minus 1 over 3 then 3 raised to the power 3 times minus 1 over 3. So this becomes 2 raised to the power of minus 2 divided by 3 raised to the power of minus 1. So this can be expressed as 1 over 2 raised to the power of 2 divided by 1 over 3. And that is equivalent to 1 over 4 divided by 1 over 3, which is similar to 1 over 4 times 3 over 1, and that gives you 3 over 4. So x is equal to 3 over 4, making option D the correct option. So let's take a look at another question. We are going to look at question number 8 from 2005. So let's take a look at this question. So the question states that if log 2 to base 10 is equal to 0.3010 and log 3 to base 10 is equal to 0.4771. So the question states that we should look for log 4.5 to base 10. So this is the question. So this is a special kind of logarithm question where they will give you certain logs and tell you to find another log. This is a kind of evaluation. They want to evaluate 4.5, log 4.5, given that you know log 2 and log 3. When you are presented with this question, your goal is to express 4.5 as a product of whatever you are given, as a product of 2 and 3. So just find a way to write this 4.5 as a product of this smaller numbers. Because what you need to do that is, if you don't do that, you will make use of this information given to you. You need to make, the question expects to make use of this information, and that can only be achieved if you can get something like log 2 or log 3 out of this 4.5. So how do we go about this? So how you go about it is to first try to convert it. If you have a decimal, try to convert it into a fraction to make it easier for you to see the pattern. So here you have 4.5, which can be written as 45 over 10, right? Then if you divide this by 5, you get 9. If you divide this by 5, you get 2. So essentially, we have it as 9 over 2. Now, we are still looking for 3 because we don't have 9. We don't have log 9 here. So what do? You can express 9 as 3 raised to the power of 2 divided by 2. So now we've got ourselves numbers in terms of 3 and 2. Okay, so what we need to do here is to say log 4.5 to base 10 is equal to log 3 raised to the power of 2 over 2 to base 10. Now, what do we do next? We try to reverse one of the laws of logarithm. You know, there's a law that states that if you have log n to base 10 minus log n to base 10, what you do basically is you multiply the numbers, you divide the numbers rather to base 10. I can go the other way around. So if I have log n over m, m over n rather to base 10, I can reverse it by saying m to base 10 minus log n to base 10. So that's exactly what I'm going to do here. So I'm going to reverse this by saying log 3 to base 2. 3 raised to the power of 2 to base 10 minus log 2 to base 10, right? So then the next thing is to take this power down. So that gives you 2 log 3 to base 10 minus log 2 to base 10. Now we've got our log 4.5 in terms of log 3. In terms of log 2. So let's substitute their values and evaluate. From the previous page, we had 2 log 3 to base 10 minus log 2 to base 10. Now we know that log 3 to base 10 is 0.4771. And we know that log 2 to base 10 is 0.3010. So if you multiply 2 by this, you're going to get 2, 4, then you have 5, then you have 9.0 minus 0.3010. So if you subtract this, you're going to get 2, 3, 5, 6, so 0.6532. So that is the answer. And that makes option B to be the right option. Let's move on to the last question. This time around, we're going to solve question from 2012, question 6. 2012, question 6. So the question states that if you have log x raised to the power of 2 to base 3 is equal to minus 8. The question is, what is x? Okay, so we know that in one of the laws that we can say that the number is equal to the base raised to the power of the result, which is minus 8. This is one of the laws. Now, the next phase is to solve for x. There are several approaches, but a very easier approach is to just take this and multiply and add another exponent, which is the reciprocal of this. So take the reciprocal of this, which is 1 over 2, and that cancels out this exponent. So since you are adding an extra exponent here, I'm going to add that same exponent on the right side. Anything you do on the left side, you do that on the right side. So if you clear this, you're going to have x equals this as 4. So you have 3 raised to the power of minus 4. And based on the laws of indices, you can express 3 raised to the power of minus 4 as 1 over 3 raised to the power of 4. And that will give you 1 over 81. You know, 3 times 3 times 3 times 3 will give you 81. So basically, it's 1, this 9 times 9, that's 1 over 81. So the right option here is option D. So that is the solution for this particular question. So in the next video, we're going to talk about application of log reading.